Hi, this video is part of a four-part VPS video course that covers why you should be using a VPS, creating a VPS and signing in, loading your MetaTrader platform and robots into your VPS, and creating portfolios up to 32 MetaTrader accounts. Please make sure that you watch these videos in sequence. Today, I'm going to show you how I sign up for a VPS service. It's going to be the Contabo VPS service. And why do I use that one? Many of our clients on the forum have reported incredibly good service from that particular company. It is a German company. And if you look at the prices involved, and these are Australian dollars, so for $8.49, you get four CPU cores that allows quite a lot of processing to happen, adequate for MetaTrader trading, and you get 8 gigs of RAM. Also, that facilitates really fast response times. So this package, although it is the small package, that's the medium one and that's the large one, I'm going to focus on the small one, because using the small package, we will be able to create many, many MetaTrader platforms. And that is the purpose of this too, is to use a VPS that will provide you with the ability to trade portfolios. And portfolios consist of many, many accounts. That small package will obviously also be adequate if you only want to use one trading account for all your trading. That is also a method to run a portfolio. You can run 20 or 30 strategies on one trading account if the account firstly is big enough, you have enough money in it, and you're able to tell the profitability of each strategy very accurately. So that package covers the one account trader, but it also covers the account trader that wants to trade a portfolio of separate accounts. Okay, so let's go and sign up for this VPS service. Okay, I'm on the Contabo website and here we are. It is currently giving the prices to Australian traders. If you want to look at prices for your particular location, all you do here is you change your location to the one you might want to be trading from. So let's go and have a look. Let's go to the UK, for instance. So let's say you're from the UK. All you do is you click on over there and you change to UK and you say you want your prices quoted in pounds, and you click save, and there we are. Now we have the prices in pounds, and the pound price, as you can see, is 6.99. Okay, so I'm going to go back to Australia and I need the prices quoted in US dollars. And there we are. There is the price in US dollars, $8.49 a month. And so all I'm going to do, and as I said, we're going to go for the small package. We click on select. Then it says, how do you want to configure your VPS? Now, if you have no experience with VPS trading, don't be intimidated by that. All you do is you do exactly what I'm going to do. There is the package we've decided on. We're going to go for 4 cores, 8 megs of RAM. We're going to go down here and we're going to just do it for 1 month, because what we want to do is just assess it for 1 month. If you like it, then you can increase the period from there. And we are going to go for the Australian option. It automatically registers that I am from Australia, and it's already included the Australian option in my price. So now the price has gone up to $11.39. Not too serious. And then let's move on a little bit more. So then we need storage space. We can just keep that storage place. That is plenty for us. We then go down to what I would call the operating systems that are available to us. And basically what that does is it allows you to use the files the way you normally would. And to do that, you would need a Windows Server software. If you are good at coding and all that type of thing, there you can use all the others, but the easiest option is just to go for Windows software. So there we are. That adds another $8.99. So now we're up to $20.38. And there is a one-time service fee of $8.49. So our total due today, if we were to go for the 1 month period, is $28.87. Now that sounds quite high. It is not, if you compare what we're getting, the bang for our buck that we're getting from this service is most probably four times that what you would get from any other service. Okay, so let's carry on. So we've decided on the Windows server. We now move down and it says, okay, now you've got to give yourself a password. Now you can generate a new password like that. And if you press this a few times, you can get some short ones or you can get long ones and so on. So the biggest and most important thing here is that you must remember this password. This is a critical password that you're going to be using throughout the service, and therefore you need to remember the service. You can enter your own password if you like, and you can change the password later on when you are in your account. So I'm going to go with just this allocated password. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight it and copy it. And I'm going to actually copy it into a place where I will remember that password. So there I have that password. And very important that you keep that. On the networking side, don't worry. Just go for what there is. And on the add-ons, there are no need to do add any add-ons. So now we're ready to pay. So there is the first month's payment, and then the second month's payment will be the $20.38 after that. There is a setup fee there. So let's click on next. And I'm going to say I'm a private individual. I'm going to enter all my details in here, in there. And I'm going to enter my email over here. Now I'll do that in the background, but that is what you would need to do, is enter all of those details. And once you've done that, you just click on next. It gives a number of payment options, PayPal, credit cards. So there are a number of options that you can use. So once you've done that, just click on next. Okay, so after clicking next, it says, okay, how do you want to pay? Do you want to use credit cards, PayPal, or other? And there are the details you need to fill in. PayPal, you will be directed to the PayPal website to complete that payment. So you control your payments through PayPal. I like PayPal because you can actually just go and cancel a subscription at any time. So once you've made your selection, just click on next. Then it asks you just to review your order prior to paying. And you can just go through all the details there with your personal details here. You can make sure that you are purchasing what we've just looked at. And then you can look at the service, which is a monthly subscription of $20.38. But because there's a 10% VAT charge, I'm going to be paying $22.42. Each country has a different VAT charge. And then there's a setup fee. Again, the setup fee includes the VAT charge, or GST in our case, and that is the first month's payment. So all you then do is you say order and pay, click on that, and you complete your payment, after which you will get this thank you message for your order. So you just go through it. It's basically saying expect between 3 hours and 48 hours to set your dedicated server up, but in most cases it takes a lot shorter. Then it says that I will be receiving an email with my login details, and no action is required from me at this stage. So at this stage, all I need to do is wait for the email, which could take 3 hours up to 48 hours. I expect it to take around 6 hours. But let's have a look. The time now is 1:35 in the afternoon. I will come back to this video once I receive the email. Okay, so a lot faster than I anticipated. In fact, 20 minutes later, I received this email with the terms and conditions of the service, and it gave me my customer ID, which I blanked out, and it gave me my control panel within the Contabo website with my username and password. And then further down, it gave me the details of my VPS, which is the IP address, the server type, the location, the IP port, password, the username, and then the password. So I have blanked those out because they are personal, but the main ones we're going to focus on here is the IP address, the username, and the password. And that's all you need to worry about in terms of that email for now. So what we're going to do is we're going to actually go to our VPS service. And if you don't have remote desktop on your computer already, what you do is you go to the search function, you type in remote desktop, and it'll bring it up. It should bring up remote desktop. And there we are. And what I like doing is I then add that to my taskbar, or I just click on that particular app and it'll open the app. It will then open up and it will ask for the computer reference, and that is the reference, and we'll go back to the previous slide. That is that IP address. That is the reference they're asking for there. Then they'll ask for the username, and there is the username there, and they will ask for the password. And the password will in fact be the password that you originally entered when you applied for your account. Could also be this password. I'm not 100% sure now. It could also try both. So there's the computer reference, the username. You click on connect and it'll ask you for the password. You then enter the password, and then you should see a screen similar to this one. That in fact is your VPS desktop. It will have the reference of your computer name up there. It will have basically what you see on the screen there. If you don't see this and you see another program, just minimize the program until you can only see what you see on the screen right now. So that's how quick it is to get into your VPS. So this is in fact your VPS computer that you will be running and using from now on. Right, so the first thing we want to do is add an MetaTrader platform, and we want to add the trading robot that we're going to use. So to continue the course, please click on the next video in the sequence that you're watching. A link to that video will be in the description of this video, as well as in the first commentary of this video.